You're awake! I'm glad to see you're okay. It looks like we got sucked into the Earthpulse.
Are you all right, Eleanor? What about everyone else?
I'm fine. But...
Kill. I killed so many. Murdered. Slaughtered. It was all for him. I killed for him. But he said I was ugly. Nothing. Nothing. All for nothing. I can't. I have to kill. Die.
The whole time, she...
You're awake. Come on, we're leaving. I have to kill them.
But Ennominot is your...
It's just an illusion! A fake! A trick!
Or, what if it was really him? Then that means he betrayed me, doesn't it?
You think I can't kill a traitor like him? Why? Why wouldn't I? Just how many do you think I've killed? You, who watched me do it!
I'm... sorry.
Velvet!
Fluffy, time to wake up.
Stop calling me Luffy. I'm not a little kid anymore.
Grumble, grumble, huh? You must be feeling good.
Ennominot!
I have a fever, I'm afraid.
No, this is
at
different.
Least the new medicine's supposed to come today.
A vision of the past?
Until then, you stay in bed.
See? I killed him! It was easy! I'm used to it by now. All right, we're getting out of here! With your power!
But...
Now!
We've gotta find Aizen and the rest!
I said now! Enough! Stop it! They're the ones who need to be stopped! Isn't that right? I'll kill them! I'll kill them all!
You must calm down!
Fine. I'll calm down and look for an exit. That's what you want, right?
We have to get out of here. Let's keep moving for now.
Yeah, I guess so.
Are you all right, Lavisette?
Yeah, I am. But I'm worried about Velvet.
This may be more than he can bear. Not that I blame him. Lavisette, perhaps you should rest within me for a while.
No.
But if you don't, then...
I know. But if I hide... It'll only hurt Velvet even more. I should at least be at her side.
You really have become stronger.
But I haven't. I hate it. But there's nothing I can do to help Velvet now.
Of course there is. Having someone nearby can be all the help you need sometimes. Like when I lost my mother.
Eleanor.
So, let's keep an eye on Velvet while we search for the others, all right? Just remember that I'm always with you, Lavisette.
I know. Thank you.
I'll end this quickly.
Here! Call it Sherman! Here! Rolling serpent!
boy who called himself Ennominot. Could he really be Velvet's younger brother?
It could have been an illusion intended to torment her. Don't you agree, Eleanor?
I do. Velvet's objective is avenging her brother, after all. We've all seen how strongly she feels about it. I find it hard to believe that the one so dear to her is still alive.
I don't know what powers Ennominot possesses, but I think that really was her little brother. Velvet was able to see past Melchior's illusions. But look at her now. I just don't want to believe that the real Lafi could do such a thing.
Could it be possible that Ennominot was reborn into her brother's body?
I don't know. But if that was the case, I'm not sure Velvet would be in so much agony.
Yes, I guess. Ennominot actually being Velvet's brother. It makes a twisted sort of sense. But it's too awful.
Always be on guard! Stay in your hands! Holy shit!
Did you think you could escape me?
I won't run away!
Stay
no problems here.
It's okay. I'm tired.
Have you been journeying long, then?
10 years. My master entrusted everything to me. But I couldn't do anything.
10 years?
My wings are weak. It doesn't matter anymore.
I see. If you've been working that hard, you surely need a break. I just happened to get my hands on some prickle boar meat. I'll be cooking up a stew for dinner. But would you care to join me?
Huh? No way.
All I have on me now is this apple. Here. Once your belly is full of warm food, you'll be able to pick yourself back up. I can feel it. Your body is shouting, I want to live.
I'm a disgrace. I don't deserve to live.
Is life something you have to earn? To deserve?
Well,
these feelings are natural. You eat when you're hungry and cry when you're sad. Feeling these things is proof that we're alive.
Alive?
What's your name? Mine is Celica. Celica Crow.
I'm an exorcist. Artorius. No, Arthur. I'm Arthur.
Artorius!
What in the world was that?
Rokuro! Aizen!
You saw it too then?
Sure did. Artorius. And he called himself Arthur.
I've heard of this. The Earth in Historia. They say that events on the world's surface cast imprints on the Earthpulse that runs below.
In other words, an illusion of the past.
It's not an illusion. That was my sister. So, he managed to fool her too, is it? Yes. Yes, that must be it. That's why she freed me from the prison.
Rokuro, have you recovered from your wounds?
Yep. Tough as nails, that's old Rokuro. I'm more worried about Velvet. She okay?
How could she be okay? Ennominot is reborn, and it's her little brother.
A blade can't just be hard. It's gotta be flexible, or it'll snap the first time it meets an unexpected force. I misunderstood the true meaning of strength, and so did he.
Let's just worry about ourselves for now. This Earthpulse is completely under Ennominot's domain. We can think of it as an extension of his body.
Yeah, which means my power won't get us out of here.
Be wary. Ennominot may be the one showing us these memories. Remember, he's after Velvet.
And the two types of malevolence inside her.
True. And we may be able to use that against him to get us out of here.
What are you saying? Just use her?
If it's necessary.
We have to keep moving. Nothing will be gained by staying here. And we ought to look for Magilu. Even she doesn't deserve to be stuck here forever.
On to battle! See this?
Be proud. You made me unleash my full power.
I can fight too!
Form
Crazy
Seven!
Nice! Come on, guys!
So, what is this Earthen Historia you mentioned?
As I've said, an Earthpulse is a natural force that circulates within the land. Wind blows, water flows, birds fly, flowers bloom. All actions in nature leave their mark on the Earthpulse. These marks become etched within the land itself and remain a part of the Earthpulse, like memories.
So it's a record of the world's past.
Does it remember human and Moloch deeds?
Everything that occurs is part of nature, including the acts of humans, Molochim, and even demons.
So that means that even this very conversation is being recorded in the Earthen Historia?
Anything bad I've done in secret, any insults you've ever told behind someone's back, the land sees it all.
My insults?
It's just an example. Pay it no mind.
Does that mean that Ennominot is drawing specific memories from the Earthen Historia and showing them to Velvet?
I believe so. That's how Rokuro and I saw the same thing, even though we weren't there. With the Earth itself as his vessel, it's a trick only Ennominot could pull off.
Awfully devious for a self-styled Empyrean.
But the attack did strike home. Keep a close watch on her until we're out of the Earthpulse.
Right.
Velvet's psyche took a heavy blow there.
Yes. She's in rough shape.
How long do you think she'll last?
What do you mean?
Just what I said. Remember, hardness alone won't save you from breaking. If she keeps being shaken up like this, she won't be able to handle it.
But what can we do?
If she breaks, she breaks. Until then, we go on with our mission.
What? Can't we help her?
If you let sympathy fog your vision, you can end up crashed on a reef.
Even so, we can't just let her suffer. It's too much.
I'm fairly sure that Velvet would say the same thing if she was in Aizen's place.
And do you agree, Rokuro?
Me? I still have a debt to Velvet. I will pay it. But in the end, her fate will be something she'll have to decide for herself.
That's true, but...
Then I have a decision of my own to make. I won't give up on Velvet, no matter what.
I see. Do what you have to.
We won't stop you.
End this quickly. Finished here. Did you think you could escape me?
Welcome home, Arthur.
Hi, Celica. I fixed the fence around the house.
Oh, thank you, sweetheart. With the brigands stepping up their attacks, the town elders have been worried. But this should put their minds at ease.
No. If the brigands turn into demons, a mere fence won't stop them.
Hmm?
Nothing. Don't worry about it. I'm pretty confident in my carpentry. And the other two?
Probably at the Cape again. I've warned them 100 times that it's dangerous.
Luffy said probably badgered Velvet into going. Don't worry, she'll watch out for him.
Yeah, I can only hope that this little one grows up to be as strong as she is one day.
Huh?
You're happy, I hope.
Of course I am. I never thought I could ever be this happy.
I only wish I'd known earlier. I would have made something even nicer for you.
Oh, you made this for me?
Yeah. I put all my heart into it.
I'll cherish it always. It'll remind me of this happy day.
Let this serve as proof of our love. This I swear. I swear to protect you both with my life.
That's Lord Artorius's past.
Oh, that's rich! You mean you believe that tripe?
It's all a pack of lies. His smile, his promise, everything.
What we just saw. Was that from before the opening?
Yeah. Celica was there, and Artorius still had use of his arm. It didn't look like he was an exorcist either.
I never would have thought Lord Artorius could smile so tenderly.
But he's since become an exorcist, taking on the mantle of shepherd and the weight of the world.
All because he lost his beloved wife.
I'd understand if you wanted to back out. But at this rate, I think the time is coming. Not much longer now.
It's coming.
To think I ate up his lies without questioning a word. What a joke.
I'll end this quickly.
Dragon!
Here! 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 Here!
victory is ours.
I can fight you! Velvet didn't know those things about Artorius and Celica, did she?
Probably not. That was when the two were alone and first getting to know each other.
We were seeing glimpses of a warm, loving family. But really, it just gave me the creeps.
Same here. I could keenly feel Ennominot scheming behind everything we saw.
He's trying to get at Velvet.
I think she used to truly love Lord Artorius. Having that happy past thrust in front of her at a time like this must be tearing her apart.
Probably, but a demon like me wouldn't understand.
What Velvet is going through is horrible. Even as a human, I can scarcely imagine what it must be like. But I approach it, just a little bit, because like her, I was his pupil.
Artorius said he needed two types of malevolence to awaken Ennominot. The illusions at a ball, making sure we knew about the attack on Titania, and Ennominot appearing as her brother. If all of that was planned to extract the malevolence from her, we'd all better brace for worse to come.
You better be ready.
Be proud. You made me unleash my full power.
I won't run away!
Improve by fighting weaklings.
Many of them. Celica, I'm coming!
It's too late! Take Velvet and Lafayette and run!
I can't do that! I want to have my life with you! With our child!
Arthur!
Celica! Why? Why couldn't I? Why couldn't I protect my own family?
Remember this moment well, Artorius. Humans are weak, filled with sin.
Melchior!
The people of this village offered you and your beloved family up to the demon brigands. A sacrifice so that they could escape and hide.
No, they wouldn't.
It happens often. The reason people act on is burdened by the weight of their sins. However, I have found a method to adjust their reason.
A domain? What is this incredible power? Don't tell me the Empyrean we've been searching for was here this whole time. These Molochim.
So they have been reborn. But be not deceived. They are not the same people you knew.
Why? Why must fate be so cruel?
It appears that Ennominot's resurrection is incomplete. We must guide him until we understand why. I'll be taking these Molochim.
Wait! I'm sorry I couldn't keep my promise. I'll make things right. I'll abandon who I am. Nameless Moloch, I will forge a pact with you. I will put an end to all the pain in this world.
Do you have it in you? You who abandoned my friend's ideals and fled.
On the souls of my dead master, wife, and child, this I swear. My name is Artorius Colbrand. I have inherited the will and the strength of Claudin Asgard, former head of the Exorcists.
Very well. Let tonight's tragedy change fate and birth. Salvation.
That Moloch, it was me. You don't remember?
Not at all.
They said you were reborn as a Moloch. That means... what exactly?
The soul of a human who passed away can, given the right trigger, be reborn as a Moloch.
You're saying that Artorius' child was reborn as Lafayette?
If what we saw was real, yes.
So the female Moloch that was born along with him was...
my sister's reincarnation. But I ate her long ago.
You didn't know, right?
I knew. I had already caught on to who Ceres really was.
Velvet.
But it doesn't matter. What does it change? I'll devour anything to fulfill my goal. My sister, my brother, even the world. That's who I am. That's all I am.
That was the day all of this started, wasn't it?
Yeah, the opening. Ennominot was halfway revived and demons became visible to all.
His power also robbed almost every Moloch of their free will that day.
I never imagined that Lord Artorius's quest to change the world was so steeped in tragedy. The villagers should have never sold them out to those bandits.
It was cruel, yes, but nothing remarkable. People are capable of anything when under pressure. Even more so when they can do it under the mantle of the greater good. Velvet's family was probably the furthest outside the village circle that night.
That's pure selfishness.
Humans are selfish creatures. You should be aware of that by now. That's why you said what you said just now, even if you didn't know it. Artorius's quest to change the world, not Artorius's quest to save humanity.
I
mean no disrespect. It's just an observation.
A man with the power to change the world turned his back on the potential of humanity. That may be the biggest tragedy of that night.
The savior of the world lost all hope in its people.
Let's do our best!
Well then, let's move on. Aizen, you said a human soul can be reborn as a Moloch given the right trigger, right? Is that something that happens frequently?
I'm afraid I don't have an answer for that. We know that humans are sometimes reborn as Molochim, but not how or why. It's more likely among people with greater resonance, but the process is still a mystery.
Huh. So it's not something that happens, or that can be made to happen, easily. Ordinarily, at least.
But Velvet's sister was reborn as Ceres, and her unborn child came back as Lafayette. What are the chances of that?
It might not have been chance. They both died on the Scarlet Night. Their rebirths may have been influenced by the sacrificial ceremony.
Are you saying that Ennominot made it happen on purpose?
Call it an educated guess. But I don't think even an Empyrean can control the lives of humans or Molochim at his whim.
If it wasn't chance, it might have been destiny.
Velvet said she ate Ceres, her own sister reborn as a Moloch. How could such a horrible thing be destiny?
Sorry. I didn't mean to make light of a tragedy, but our fates intertwine, the good and the bad, whether we like it or not. That's what makes it destiny, right?
True. But this...
Get a hold of yourself, Eleanor. Velvet and Lafayette are in rougher waters than any of us. They'll be looking to you to light their way.
Yes. I must remain calm and steady.
An Earthpulse rift. We may be able to get out from there.
Arthur, there's something I'd like to speak to you about. Alone. Two souls possessing powerful resonance and free of malevolence. These must be sacrificed on the Scarlet Night.
Ah, yes. The ceremony to resurrect Ennominot. You read my book.
I haven't fully mastered the ancient tongue yet, but I have read your notes. You wrote that if Ennominot is resurrected, we can make a world free of demons.
7 years ago, a soul with strong resonance, my own unborn son, was sacrificed for that purpose. Now, Ennominot's resurrection is half complete.
Because of that, everyone's resonance has grown stronger, enabling them to see demons.
Yes, that's the truth behind the opening.
So, if one more person is sacrificed...
Ennominot's resurrection will be complete. And his power will spur the creation of many new exorcists.
And there is another Scarlet Knight very soon. Arthur, I must ask.
Lafayette?
Can't I be the sacrifice?
Tell me, why do you think that birds fly?
I think that birds fly because they must. Why else would they have wings if not to embrace the sky? I have wings too, weak as they are. That's why I must fly, now! If we miss this Scarlet Night, the next won't be for another 3 years. By then, I won't be alive.
Lafayette, why would you say such a thing?
The 12-year sickness. That's the name of my disease.
So you know.
I'm not afraid of being sick. But I don't want to just be a burden on everyone until I die. I couldn't take it.
Your wings are your will, and they are strong.
Lars! Please, you can't tell Velvet about this.
I promise.
I'll make a new world. A world where my sister can be happy.
Both of you! Together! You betrayed me!
Whoa, hey! What's everyone apologizing for? We're a family, right? Hurry back! I'll make you a quiche, just the way she taught me. No kidding. I think you'll be an exorcist to rival even him.
Shut up!
He fell further than this back at the shrine. I will have my revenge.
Revenge!
revenge for Lafayette!
Lafayette knew so much more pain than I ever will. And still, I couldn't do anything for him. I'm sorry. I'm sorry.
Shut up! It's a lie! A dirty lie! All of it! It's all their lies! And I believed it! Die! Get out of my way, you disgusting monster!
What is this thing?
An amalgamation of multiple demons?
It doesn't matter what it is! I'll devour it until it's dead!
Hoodwink!
Second!
Crimson Summit, Wendy! Crimson Summit, Wendy! Is the true face of my sister. She hates, resents, devours, and kills. She tramples people, cities, everything, living only by her emotions. What an ugly, tainted soul.
It's not like that!
Nothing you say will matter. She knows. She knows if it's the truth.
He's right. Just think, everything I did was baseless, arrogant. And even so, I still...
You hurt so many innocent people, didn't you?
More than I can count. I devoured and killed so many.
Without even knowing Arthur's true aims.
I destroyed people. I destroyed whole towns.
And worse yet, you didn't even show mercy to your own sister's reincarnation.
I hate her.
And despite all of that, I still love you, Velvet. That's why I chose to become a sacrifice. For you, sister. But think, if you try to stop the resurrection, wouldn't my death be all for nothing? To tell you the truth, I was terrified of dying. It was so dark.
I'm sorry. I'm so sorry.
You'll accept it then? That everything you've done up until this point, all of it,
yes, it was all for nothing, and for no one. I hurt so many people, all for no reason. I'm a monster.
If you've accepted it, you have to atone for your sins. Once I eat the final two malevolences inside you, I'll fully awaken. Give them to me. Give me your hatred, your despair. If you do, I can cleanse this world of all its pain. I had hoped that you could live in a world without pain and sadness. But you're a monster now. You don't belong there.
Go. We have to go.
No!
If you don't, you'll die too for no reason.
No!
A twisted monster like me doesn't deserve to live. Don't you understand?
You're the reincarnation of the first sacrifice. Part of me. Don't worry. I'll devour you too.
Lafayette, tell this self-absorbed idiot what she needs to hear!
Please, let me go.
Will you stop
love them all. I loved Laffy and Celica, Arthur, everyone. To have it all stolen from me. Why them? Why not me? It hurts so much!
Your despair, how is it gone?
A flame burns in my heart, too. A flame I cannot quench, no matter how hard I try. Just like you, Velvet.
I finally understand how you felt. But the only one I can fight for is myself.
That's good enough. That's proof that you are truly alive.